The shade and let the sun come through. Good morning, glory. Spend about an hour underneath a shower and keep on singing like the birdies do. Ho hum, ho hum. While you're waiting for your toast, call the one you love the most. Pick up the phone and start and sing. Good morning, glory. Were you dreaming of me? And do you still love me? Well, baby, here's a kiss for you. Good morning, glory. Pull up the shade and let the sun come through. Good morning, glory. Spend about an hour underneath the shower and keep on swinging like the birdies do. Ho-hum, ho-hum. While you're waiting for your toast, call the one you love the most. Pick up the phone and start and say, good morning, glory. Were you dreaming of me? And do you still love me? Well, baby, here's a kiss for you.
Plié. And two, three, four elbows up. And two, three, open four. And plié. Two, three, open. And.
Is hushed at Yankee Stadium, the house that Ruth built, as the early autumn shadows cast itself over the right field fence. The flags flap wildly in the breeze. As we move into the top of the seventh inning, with one strike on Jojo Moore, Red Ruffing pitches.
I thought it was a gunshot.
Yeah, I'll give him a gunshot.
One out. A man on second, top of the seventh, two strikes on Jojo Moore, Red Ruffing the pitcher.
What did I tell you about banging the ball? Your Aunt Blanche has a headache.
I can't stop now. It's a crucial moment in World Series history. The Yanks are playing the Giants.
I'm not going to tell you again. Do you hear me?
I don't want him to stop playing. It's just the banging.
He always does it when I'm studying.
One more pitch. I could get him to pop up. I've got my stuff today.
Your father will give you his stuff when he gets home. Get in here and put out the water glasses. Now.
I'll put out the glasses.
Why? Is his arm broken? I've told him 109 times about making noises.
Don't yell on my account.
I'm through. I got him out. I knew I had my stuff.
Wash your hands.
They're clean. I'm wearing a glove.
Don't you talk back to me.
I wasn't talking back. I was answering.
Who asked you anything? And don't answer under your breath when I walk away. Do you hear me?
Yes.
What?
I hear you. If I cut my ears off, I would still hear it through my nose.
That's enough sewing for today. That's all I need is for you to go blind.
Is your throat sore again?
No, it's the same one from before.
What are you doing in there, Eugene?
What are you doing in there, Eugene? She bellowed in her loud voice.
Eugene! Eugene!
I'm coming. I'm coming. I hate my name. Eugene Morris Jerome. How am I ever gonna play for the Yankees with a name like that? You have to be a Joe or a Tony or a Frankie. All the best Yankees are Italian. My mother makes spaghetti with ketchup. What chance do I have? Actually, I think I'm gonna be a writer. I wanna write books or plays or movies. That is, if things don't work out with the Yanks. Definitely be a writer.
Eugene? Eugene?
Hello, Eugene!
Oh, hello, Mrs. Lasky.
I thought you promised you were going to help me clean out my basement.
Oh, I am. I am.
Not for nothing. I want to give you something.
Is she thinking what I'm thinking?
You have better color today, sweetheart. Did you get a little sun this afternoon?
I walked down to the beach.
Very slowly, I hope.
Yes, Ma.
She always does what she's told, that one. Eugene, pick up those magazines.
She gets all this special treatment because the doctor says she has kind of a flutter in her heart. So I have to do all her work. She'd better have a bad heart or I'm gonna kill her one day.
What's this? What's this?
Isn't it a roller skate?
On the kitchen floor?
I didn't leave it there.
No? Who skates in the kitchen? Lori? Aunt Blanche? How many times have I told you not to leave your things around the house?
109.
What?
You said yesterday I told you 109 times not to leave your things around the house.
Don't be fresh to your mother, Eugene.
Go on, upstairs. Put it in the closet.
I'm putting all this down in my memoir, so if I grow up twisted and warped, the world will know why.
I got the new silver screen.
I have to get home. I've got the most incredible news in the world. I'll tell you tomorrow.
What's this?
My hockey puck.
On the kitchen floor. I almost killed myself. What would you tell your father if he came home and I was dead on the kitchen floor?
I'd say don't go in the kitchen, Pa.
Ooh. Hey! Hey, shoes on the bed. That's bad luck in a Jewish house.
It's not a Jewish house. It was built by Italians.
You are looking to get it from me. I need Swiss cheese. Go to Greenblatt's.
Now?
No, next year when I'm dead. Tell him 4 thin slices. You hear me? Very thin.
I know, the kind you can see through.
And don't forget the deposit on the empty milk bottle. Don't climb so fast, sweetheart. You'll get overheated.
Sid Luckman of Columbia awaits the snap from Senna. The snow is coming down in a near blizzard. He gets it. He fades back. He passes. And Luckman's got it. Luckman catches his own pass.
Hey, watch it.
He's on the 50. The 40. The 35.
Crazy.
The 30. The 25. Oh, my God.
Sorry, Gene. I didn't see you.
Hello, Mr. Murphy. My mother's going to kill me. It's a deposit box.
It wasn't your fault.
She doesn't care. She'll charge me for my own dessert tonight.
I should have seen you coming. How much is the deposit?
3 cents.
Here, here. Here's a dime.
Dime?
I'm a sports fan, and that was a great run.
Gee, thanks, Mr. Murphy.
Oh, say hello to your Aunt Blanche for me, huh?
I will. He'll do anything to get in good with Aunt Blanche. That's why I purposely dropped the bottle.
What am I going to do about him, Blanche? I found lima beans in his closet. I didn't look, they grow into a tree.
He's young. He'll grow out of it. You think Nora's any better the way she leaves her clothes around?
Girls are different. But the day Mama had to pack up and leave the house in Russia, she cleaned the place from top to bottom. She said no matter what the Cossacks did to us when they broke into her house, they would have respect for the Jews. Yes.
Who are the Cossacks?
Same filthy bunch that lives across the street.
You mean the Murphys?
All of them.
The mother is nice. She's been very sweet to me.
Her windows are so filthy, I thought she had black curtains hanging inside.
I think Frank Murphy is sweet on Mom.
You mean that drunken son of hers?
Kate, stop it.
Listen, he knows your situation. I know their kind. Remember what Mama used to say to us? Stay on your own side of the street. That's what they have gutters for.
Is that thin enough?
A little thinner. Ma likes it when it floats. That's better. Died?
Mr. Nunzio.
The shoemaker? Wow, what happened?
He had cancer.
Why is it old people always whisper what someone dies from? Like my Uncle Dave, Aunt Blanche's husband. He died from a coronary. People from the old country think it's bad luck to say a disease out loud. Like if God hears you, he'll give it to you. My grandfather died from diphtheria. Anyway, after Uncle Dave died, he left Aunt Blanche with no money, not even insurance. And she couldn't support herself because she has asthma. So my big-hearted mother took her in with her 2 daughters, and my father had to take another job to support us all. Besides cutting raincoats, he also sells party favors to nightclubs. But I think it's getting to him, because I heard Mom say that Pop was developing high blood pressure.
Wait till I tell you what's happened to me! You're not going to believe this, Mama. You're just not going to believe it.
Well, tell us already. The suspense is killing me.
Oh, Lori, don't say things like that.
What is it, Nora? What happened?
Tell us. What is it?
She takes so long.
I'm going to be in a Broadway show. It It's a musical called Abracadabra. This man, Mr. Beckman, he's a producer, came into our dancing class this afternoon, and he picked out three girls. They start rehearsing a week from Monday, and then it goes to Philadelphia, Wilmington, Washington, and then it comes to New York the second week in December. There are 9 big musical numbers. And there's going to be a big glass tank on the stage that you can see through. And the big finale all takes place with the entire cast all underwater. I mean, can you believe it? I'm going to be in a Broadway show, Mama!
What's she talking about?
Do I know? Am I her mother?
How can you be in a show? Don't you have to sing and act?
I can sing.
No, you can't.
A little.
No, you can't.
I can carry a tune.
No, you can't.
Well, I probably won't have to. They're just looking for dancers.
Did you tell him how old you were?
He didn't ask me.
He didn't ask if you were 16?
He just asked me to audition. My God, isn't anybody excited?
I am. It's the most fantastic thing I ever heard.
Thanks, Eugene. Glad somebody's excited.
How can you go to Philadelphia? What about school?
Mama, this is a Broadway show. This is what I want to do with my life. Algebra and English isn't going to help me on the stage.
Aren't.
Will you stay out of this?
Forget about school. Do you know how hard it is today for a girl to get a good job without a high school diploma? Tell her, Kate.
It's very hard.
Then I'm asking you something else. Let me do something for you now. I could be making almost $60 a week, maybe even more. I wouldn't make that much today with a college diploma.
It was a tense moment for everybody. I love tense moments. Especially when I'm not the one they're all tense about.
Uncle Jack will be home soon. We'll discuss it at dinner.
Can you believe it? 16 years old?
I have to know now, Mama. I have to call Mr. Beckman and let him know if I can go to the audition on Monday. Please, don't say no until Monday.
We will leave it up to Uncle Jack. He knows about these things. We'll let him make the decision.
Why, Mama? I love him, but he's not my father.
Because I need help. Because I don't always know what the right thing to do is. Because I say so! That's why.
You have nothing better to do. I need bread.
What?
I don't have enough bread. Run over to Greenblatt's and get me a fresh rye bread.
I just came back from Greenblatt's.
So you'll go again.
I'm always going to the store. When I grow up, that's all I'll be trained to do, go to the store.
You don't want to go? Never mind, I'll go.
Don't do that. Don't make me feel guilty. I'll go.
And get a quarter of a pound of butter.
I bought a quarter pound of butter this morning. Why don't you buy a half a pound at a time?
And suppose the house burned down this afternoon. Why do I need an extra quarter pound of butter?
If my mother taught logic in high school, this would be some weird country.
Now you're a complainer.
If I had my choice between a tryout with the Yankees and actually seeing Nora's bare breasts for 2.5 seconds, I would have some serious thinking to do.
Hey, Eugene! Did Pop get home yet?
No. You look terrible. What's wrong?
I'm in trouble, Huge. I mean, really big trouble.
What kind of trouble?
Not here. Pop could pass by. Down at the beach. I got fired today.
Fired? You mean for good?
You don't get fired temporarily. It's a permanent lifetime firing. It was on account of Andrew, the colored guy who sweeps up. Well, he was cleaning the floor in the stock room, and he lays his broom against the table to put some junk in the trash can. The broom slips, knocks a can of linseed oil over the table, and ruins three brand new hats right out of the box. $9 Stetsons. It wasn't his fault. He didn't put the linseed oil there, right?
Right.
So Mr. Stroheim sees the oily hats, and he gets crazy. He says to Andrew, the hats are going to have to come out of his salary, $27. So Andrew starts to cry.
He cried?
42 years old. He's bawling all over the stockroom. Anyway, I said to Mr. Stroheim, I didn't think that was fair. It wasn't Andrew's fault. So Mr. Stroheim screams at me.
When I tell you something, you listen to me. You want to pay for the hats, Big Mouth?
No, I don't want to pay for the hats.
Then mind your own business, Big Mouth. I want you to bring the hats back to the factory. You know where it is?
The factory?
He doesn't know that's my job.
Am I speaking to you, Big Mouth? Yes, Mrs. Ludwig. She will tell you where the factory is. They will give you three new hats. And if I see a finger mark on them, you'll pay for them too. You understand?
Yes, sir.
And don't stand around here. You wasted enough time today. Back to work. This is not the lunch hour. You! Take the broom. You sweep up this week. You are the cleaning man. Again, this account. In it. I told you 50 million hunters.
Stroheim's. I don't think you're being fair.
You sweep that up, or today is your last day here.
You want me to sweep it up? I'll sweep it up.
Inside. You hear me? Inside! A letter of apology, which I will put on the wall for everyone to see. On my desk, 9 o'clock tomorrow morning. Otherwise, don't bother coming in. Understood?
I understand, Mr. Stroheim. That's something I'll just have to think about tonight. I'll finish sweeping up the floor. I don't know why I did it, but I got so mad. I mean, if you give in when you're 18 and a half, you'll give in for the rest of your life, don't you think?
I suppose so. So what's the decision? Are you gonna write the letter?
No.
Positively?
Positively. Except I'll have to discuss it with Pop. I know we need the money, but he told me once, you always have to do what you think is right in this world and stand up for your principles. Come on, he'll be home soon.
Stanley's home.
Shh, I have a cake in the oven. I never understand why we have to whisper. Is a cake afraid of people?
Come on, watch your face. Give me the bread.
Hi, Mom.
Shh. The cake is sleeping.
Eugene! He purposely does this to aggravate me.
Shh.
I don't get a kiss alone.
That's what I wait for all day.
Mm-hmm. Oh, a hug, too.
When do I ever get a hug from you? You must have done something wrong.
You're just a cute lady, Mom. I can't help myself. I think I'll wash up.
Don't forget to ask your boss to get paid tomorrow. Saturday's a holiday.
I won't.
Eugene, I hear the train. Go meet your father.
Lori, it's time for your medicine. I feel so tired suddenly.
If you drink my medicine, I'll eat your liver.
What liver?
We're having liver and cabbage for dinner.
Oh, my God. Liver and cabbage. A Jewish medieval torture. My friend, Marty Gregorio, an A student in science, told me that cooked cabbage can be smelled farther than sound traveling for 7 minutes.
Didn't I tell you to get out of that hot kitchen? Huh?
I'm all right.
Come here.
Just let me get a minute.
You sit down. I can't breathe in there, and I don't have asthma.
Oh, I'm sick about your picture. You go, Kristoff.
Oh, okay. Stop it.
I'll replace it. Please don't worry about it.
I can always get pictures. Sisters, I can't always find.
Well, don't touch a broken glass. I'll clean it up.
You right sit away. Right there. Eugene will clean it up when he gets back.
Let me help you, Pop.
Be careful. You'll hurt yourself.
No. No trouble. How you doing, Pop?
Good.
I don't know how you do it, Pop. Carrying these boxes back and forth every day. King Kong couldn't lift these.
You do what you have to do. Why are you walking funny?
Oh, it's my sneakers. The soles wore off. I have to clench my toes when I walk.
Can't you wear Stanley's old pair?
Stanley's wearing Stanley's old pair. They're okay. I try to walk on my heels because I have no skin left on my toes.
Feeling better, Mom?
Much better, dear.
You feeling better, Mom?
Much better, dear.
Jack, what's the matter? What's wrong? Eugene said you were holding your chest.
I wasn't holding my chest.
Carrying those boxes back and forth every day. You're getting older, Jack. Don't you work hard enough?
You want the boxes? They're yours. Keep them. I don't need them anymore.
What do you mean?
Del Mar Party Favors went out of business. They closed them out. The man is bankrupt.
Oh, my God.
Never even warned me it was coming.
You told me he lived up on Riverside Drive. A $300 a month apartment he had, a man like that.
Who are the ones you think go bankrupt? You live in a cold water flat with rats running around. Bankruptcy is the one thing God spares you.
What are you doing?
Astronomy. I have to bring in a report tomorrow.
Let me know when she gets to the Milky Way.
Damn. That dirty little pig. He's watching Nora getting undressed. I wonder if he'd let me come over.
Can't get by without that extra $25 a week.
Stop it, Jack. You'll only make yourself sick.
He didn't even pay me for the week, the bastard. 5 salesmen are laid off. He's going to a Broadway show tonight. I stuffed every hat and noisemaker I could carry into those boxes, walked out of there. At his funeral, I'll put on a pointy hat and blow a horn, the bastard.
Something will come up. You'll go to temple this weekend. You'll pray all day Saturday.
There's men in that temple have been praying for 40 years. You know how many prayers have to get answered before my turn comes up?
Your turn will come up. God has time for everybody.
Stanley! Eugene! Time to eat!
Remember, if you see a chance to help me out with Pop, just jump in. Will you do it?
I was waiting for a chance to get in the game. Just give me the ball, Coach.
Don't say anything about the Broadway show to Uncle Jack. Let me introduce the subject. Not a lot of talk while I'm eating anyway.
Please, don't think about this during dinner. You'll just give yourself heartburn.
Jack, hey,
we're coming.
Gone. You think she'll ever get married?
Blanche?
She's not unattractive. I see men look at her on the beach. What does she want to waste her life in this house for?
Blanche isn't the type to get married.
She was married once, wasn't she? Those are the type that get married.
Dave was different. She isn't interested in other men.
What about that Murphy fellow across the street? He's plenty interested, believe me.
That drunk? The man can't find his way into the house at night. He slept in the doorway once in the rain. He was there when I went out to get the milk.
He's got a good paying job, lives alone with his mother, so he takes a drink on a Saturday night. Maybe what he needs is a good woman.
Not my sister.
Jack, hey!
Let him meet someone lying in the next doorway.
Chapter 7, The Infamous Dinner. It started out like a murder mystery. No one said a word, but everyone looked suspicious. Everyone had one eye on their plate and the other eye on Pop.
Pickles?
Except me. I sat opposite Nora.
Relish?
I kept dropping my napkin a lot so I could bend down and get a good look at those virginy, creamy white legs.
Ketchup.
She was really deep in thought because she left herself unguarded a few times. And I got to see halfway up her thighs that led to the golden palace of the Himalayas.
Eugene! Keep your napkin on your lap.
Stanley knew what I was doing because he's the one who taught it to me. You could hear the clock ticking in the kitchen. The tension in the air was so thick you could cut it with a knife, which is more than I could say for the liver.
With the dessert.
Finish your liver.
Finish. You see liver on my plate?
You buried it under your potatoes. I know your tricks. Look how Lori ate hers.
One more bite and I would have thrown up on the table. A sight Nora would have remembered forever. A diversion was my only escape from humiliation.
So how things down at Stroheim's, Stanley?
Yeah.
I felt bad about that. But for the moment, the tension had shifted away from my liver.
How long you been working there now?
Where?
At Stroheim's.
At Stroheim's? About a year and a half.
And he likes you?
Who?
Stroheim.
Yeah, usually he likes me.
You come in on time?
Always.
You do your work? You get along with the other people? Why shouldn't he like you? Tomorrow, you go in and ask him for a raise.
A raise?
I wanted to cut my wrists, but the liver had worn down the knives.
Your father wouldn't ask you if he didn't think it was the right thing. Believe me, Stanley, now is the time to ask.
I think I have a bone in my throat.
There are no bones in liver.
So what's new at dancing school, Nora?
Nothing's new. Mind your own business.
I'm just trying to introduce the subject.
What happened at dancing school?
Nora received a very nice compliment from Mr. Beckman. He said that she had professional talent.
Mr. Beckman is your teacher?
No. Mr. Beckman is one of the most widely known and respected producers on Broadway.
Broadway? Imagine that.
Isn't that the same Mr. Beckman who's producing the great Broadway extravaganza, Abracadabra? I hear if a girl gets a part for the chorus of a show like that, not only is her career practically guaranteed, but the experience she gains is equal to a 4-year college education.
Eugene, that's enough. Boys, let your father finish his dinner.
It's all right. This is the time to discuss things. This is the family hour.
What a great idea for a radio show. The family hour. Every Wednesday, you hear a different family eating dinner and discussing their problems of the week, and you get to hear different recipes. WEAF presents Dinner at Brighton Beach, starring the Jacob Jerome family and featuring tonight's specialty, liver and cabbage. Brought to you by Ex-Lax, the mild laxative.
Eugene, sit down!
Nothing more to discuss, anybody. Otherwise, I want to turn on the news.
Finish your liver, I said.
I can't swallow it. It won't go down.
Eat half.
Which half? They're both terrible.
Just one bite.
If I take one bite, you'll make me take two bites. I'll take it to my room. I'll eat it tonight.
If nobody likes liver, why do you make it?
Because we can't afford a roast beef for 7 people.
These are not times to waste food, Eugene. If you didn't want it, you shouldn't have taken it.
I didn't take it. They gave it to me. It comes attached to the plate.
Can I talk to you for a minute, Pop? It's something really important.
More important than what's going on in Europe? Who's been playing around with this radio? Eugene, he's talking about Poland, damn it. I don't want anyone touching this radio anymore, you understand?
Guess who's gonna get blamed for the war in Europe?
Why should anything be wrong with this radio? Which one of you has been fooling around with it?
I have to know tonight, Mother, because I have to let Mr. Beckman know if I can do the show or not.
Nora, not now. It's not the time.
It's never the time. You won't make a decision, and I don't have anyone else I can talk to. I'll make my own decisions if no one else is interested.
Nora!
Damn it!
You really think there'll be a war, Pop? I mean, America, too?
We're already in it. Not us, maybe, but all our relations in Europe.
Doesn't Mom have aunts and nephews there?
Aunts and nephews? I have a cousin, Sholem, in Poland.
With 6 children, right?
With 6 children, right. God knows what'll happen to them.
Jack, go and talk to Nora. You're the only one she'll listen to.
What if they all got to America, Pop? Where would they live? Would we take them in?
What God gives us to deal with, we'll deal with.
But where would we put them if they got off the boat and knocked on our door? How would we feed them?
The boat didn't get here yet. I can't deal with boats that haven't landed yet.
I'll talk to you later, okay, Pop? Before you go to bed.
Where are you going? Let me see what Nora to the drugstore. I'm going to get my asthma medicine.
I'll get it. You shouldn't be out at night.
Kate, you have got to stop thinking everybody is your responsibility.
Hey, Stan, who do you think has the best boobs in the neighborhood?
Jeez. Is sex the only thing you ever have on your mind?
I think Mrs. Lasky has. Boy, would I love to wrap my hands around them.
She's jumbo size. Your hands aren't big enough.
If I wore two baseball gloves, they would be.
Can I give you a lift home, Mrs. Morton?
Oh, hello, Mr. Murphy. It's only two blocks.
It's not the distance, it's the company.
All right. Thank you. Ooh, is this your car?
Mine? No, no. Cars are luxuries, and I have no aspirations for luxuries. I do, however, have a weakness for friends who have aspirations for luxuries.
Well.
You've an Irish smile, you know.
I don't at all.
Is that what they call blondie, Mr. Murphy?
Yes, it is, definitely. But it's a handy way of getting the attention of someone. You want to be sure is taking notice of you. I've taken notice of you, Mrs. Morton, many months now.
Yes, Mr. Murphy, I've taken notice.
I had a dream last night. It was about a girl. I can't tell you her name, but she was gorgeous. We were really kissing hard. And rubbing up against each other. And I felt this tremendous build-up coming. And suddenly, there was this explosion. Like a dam broke. And suddenly, everything rushed and flowed out to sea. It was the greatest feeling I ever had in my life. And when I woke up, I was
all wet. It was a wet dream. You had a wet dream. I have them all the time.
You do? You mean there's nothing wrong with you if it happens?
You never had one before?
Yeah, but I slept through it.
Didn't you ever try to do it by yourself?
What do you mean?
Didn't you ever diddle with yourself?
No, never.
Baloney, I've heard you. You diddle 3-4 times a week.
You're crazy.
I think you've gone 5 blocks out of your way.
8 blocks? I know a shortcut that can add another 6.
Oh, my God.
What's wrong?
It's my sister. Please stop the car. I have to get out.
But you'd rather not be seen with me?
No, honestly.
She doesn't care for me. I know that.
But she's never said that.
Some people think I'm a bit carefree in my ways, but I'm an honest man, Mrs. Morton, and I would never show you any disrespect.
I'm sure of that, Mr. Murphy.
Then will you have dinner with me next Wednesday night at Chardos Restaurant? It's a very respectable family establishment.
Yes, I will. Thank you for the ride.
Kate, what are you doing out?
Oh, I told Lori I'd get her some liquor. She woke up drenched in perspiration. Come on. I'm dying for something sweet.
Nothing wrong with it. Everybody does it, especially at our age. It's natural.
I can't believe I'm having this conversation.
You can't grow up without doing it. Your voice won't change.
Where do you get this stuff from? Is it in a medical book or something?
It's puberty.
It's what?
Puberty! You never heard that word before? Don't you read books?
Yeah.
the Count of Monte Cristo had never mentioned puberty. Even Pop did it. Pop? Our Pop? You know what, Stanley? I think you're full of shit.
Don't you use that language. You're just a kid. Never let me hear you say that word again.
I don't get you. You mean it's okay for you to say puberty, but I can't say shit?
Puberty is a scientific word. Shit is for those guys who hang around the beach.
Well, what do you expect me to say when you tell me that Pop whacks off?
I don't mean he still does it because he's married now. But when he was a kid, 14, 15, the whole world whacks off.
President Roosevelt, too?
Sometimes I forget his birthday, but the day he died, I will never forget.
Sometimes you talk like your life is over. You're still an attractive woman if you'd only stop squinting so much. You gotta get out of the house more.
I'll get out.
Jack's company is having their annual affair in New York next Wednesday at the Commodore Hotel. Jack wants you to come with us. He told me to ask you.
Hey, how do I know in Jack's company?
He'll be with us. He'll meet people. Max Green will be at our table. He's their number one salesman. He's a riot. You'll love him. He's a widower. His wife died last year. Tuberculosis.
I appreciate it, Kate, but I've made plans for next Wednesday night.
More important than this, they only have this affair once a year.
I'm having dinner with someone.
You're having dinner with a man. That's wonderful. Why didn't you tell me?
With Mr. Murphy.
Who is Mr. Murphy? Oh, my God. You're going to have dinner with that man. Do you know where he'll take you? To a bar and grill. That's where he'll take you.
We are going to Chardoff's, the Hungarian restaurant. You've never met him. How can you dislike him so much?
I don't have to meet that kind. I just have to smell his breath when he opens the window.
Do girls whack off, too?
Five times as much as boys.
Five times as much? Is that an actual figure? Where do you know all this from?
You pick it up. You learn it. It's handed down from generation to generation. That's how our culture spreads.
Five times as much as boys. Some of them don't even say hello to you when they're home all night whacking off.
They're human just like we are. They have the same needs and desires.
Arms that held me, lips that thrilled me.
How do girls do it?
I can't explain it. Come on, I'll buy you an ice cream.
Please, Stanley. I'll be a slave for a month. Tell me how they do it.
Hey, Eugene, I have a major problem in my life. I haven't got time to describe girls masturbating for you.
Just draw me a picture. I brought a pencil. You want crayons? Maybe you should do it in color.
Hey! What do you think a man like that is looking for? We grew up with that kind on Avenue A. How many times have Stanley and Eugene come home from school black and blue from the beatings they got from those Irish hooligans, huh?
You're not being fair, Kate. Yeah. We went for a walk along the beach Thursday night. He couldn't have been more polite. He told me where his parents came from in Ireland. Their life wasn't any easier than mamas and papas in Russia.
Nobody had it like they had it in Russia.
He holds down a decent job in a printer's shop, and he didn't smell of liquor, and he behaved like a perfect gentleman.
That was on the beach. They're different when the sun goes down. I don't care. Do what you want.
I bet Nora doesn't do it.
Boy, could I win money from you. Think she's in the bathroom seven times a day just taking showers?
Don't believe it. Not Nora.
Is she the one you were dreaming about last night?
No. It was somebody else. It was one of the beach girls.
It was Nora. I see what's going on. That's why you dropped your napkin 12 times at dinner.
She drives me crazy. I think I'm in love with her.
Well, forget it. She's your cousin.
What's wrong with being in love with your cousin?
Because it's against the laws of nature. You can't marry your first cousin. You get babies with 9 heads.
I don't think one dinner with Frank Murphy at Chardoff's restaurant is the end of the world.
I just don't want to see you get hurt, that's all. I never mean you harm. I can take anything except when someone in the family is mad at me.
Oh, I could never be mad at you, Kate. That I promise you to my dying day.
Yeah, well, don't expect me to be too friendly with you. I'll put out nuts, but I won't put out the...
Can I see Mr. Beckman tomorrow? Yes or no?
Did you talk to your Uncle Jack?
It doesn't matter what he said. It's your decision or mine. Who's going to make it, Mother?
I said, if I were her father, I'd tell her to finish high school. If she's got talent, there'll be plenty of other shows. Be patient, I said.
Don't shut me in, Mama. Don't shut me in for the rest of my life.
You promised you'd do what Uncle Jack said.
He doesn't make decisions. He offers advice. I want a decision, Mama, from you. Please.
You finish high school. You tell Mr. Beckman you're too young. You tell him your mother said. No. That's my decision.
I see. Thank you very much, Uncle Jack, for your advice. I'll let you know in the morning what my decision is.
I would love to see Nora naked. Just once. Wouldn't you?
I have. Plenty of times.
You've seen Nora naked?
Sure. Fixed the lock on the bathroom door, then opened it, pretending I didn't know anyone was there.
What a disgusting pig.
Will you show me how to work it?
Hello, boys.
Oh, hello, Mr. Murphy.
Hi. Lovely night. Lovely night indeed. Yes, indeedy. Yes, indeedy.
I think that guy thinks he's in a Shakespeare play.
He had a couple in there, I bet.
You think he and Anne Blanche do it?
Nah, she's a widow. Widows don't do those things.
Don't hate me for what I'm gonna say.
What is it?
I think Aunt Blanche has a great ass.
They're gonna lock you up in a sex asylum. If I was your sister, I wouldn't sleep on the same block with you.
What if they took a shower together, Aunt Blanche and Nora? If I could walk in and see that, I would thank God and become a rabbi.
Come on. When does it get easier, Kate?
When you get 7 good hours sleep a night, that's the easiest it ever gets.
He's home.
You gonna talk to him now?
It's now or never.
Good luck.
Hi, Pop. You think we could have that talk now?
Did you fix the radio?
It works better than new.
It's almost 10 o'clock. I can get the late news soon.
Well, I'm gonna finish my homework. Good night.
Put the cookie on the table.
What cookie?
The oatmeal cookie in your pocket. Put it on the table.
You can smell an oatmeal cookie from 10 feet away?
I heard the jar moving in the kitchen. Suddenly, everybody is doing what they want in this house. Your father's upset. Aunt Blanche is upset. Nora is upset. Put the cookie on the table!
Think we could sit outside, Pop? Everyone's always coming through here.
The nose is coming on.
Talk wherever you want. I'm going to bed.
5 minutes, that's all.
Eugene!
What? Give me that cookie.
Why don't you sit down, Pop?
Some buildup this is.
Pop, I have a problem.
If you didn't, you wouldn't live in this house.
Close the door! Close the door!
I'm sorry! Something must be wrong with the lock.
It must be tough being a father. Everybody comes to you with their problems. You have to have all the answers. I don't know if I could handle it.
Stop trying to win me over. Just tell me the problem.
I got fired today.
What?
Don't get excited. Don't get crazy. Let me explain what happened.
What did you do? You came in late? You were fresh to somebody? Were you fresh to somebody?
I'm not fired yet. I could still get my job back. I just need you to help me make a decision.
Take the job back. I don't care what it is. This is not the time for anybody in this family to be out of work.
She saw me on the crapper. Nora saw me on the crapper. I might as well be dead.
Be careful when you go into the bathroom. The lock's broken.
Who cares? Nobody wants to see me coming out of the shower.
What do you mean?
I mean that some people in this house are very handy with screwdrivers.
When I was 12 years old, you gave me a talk about principles. Do you remember?
Principles are one thing. Losing your job is another.
Can I at least tell you what happened?
Tell me any story you want, as long as it has a happy ending.
It was all on account of Andrew, the colored guy who sweeps up.
So Stanley told the whole story. He delivered it like the Gettysburg Address. Pop must have been bleary-eyed, because not only did he have to deal with Stanley's principles, Nora's career, the loss of his noisemaker business, had to get Aunt Blanche married off and Laurie's fluttering heart, but at any minute there could be a knock on the door with 37 relatives from Poland showing up looking for a place to live.
So either I bring in a letter of apology in the morning or I don't bother coming in.
Oh, Stanley. Stanley. Stanley.
I'm sorry, Pop.
You shouldn't have swept the dirt on his shoes.
I know.
Especially in front of other people.
I know.
He's your boss. He pays your salary. His money helps put food on our dining table.
No, Pop. I can see what you're getting at.
On the other hand, you did a courageous thing. You defended a fellow worker. Nobody else stood up for him, did they?
I was the only one.
Well, that's something to be proud of. It was what you believed in. That's standing up for your principles.
That's why I didn't want to write the letter. See, I knew you'd understand.
The question is, can this family afford principles right now?
It would make it hard, I know.
On everyone. Eugene would have to quit school, go to work.
Wants to go to college, wants to be a writer.
I wish I could have sent you. I've always been sick about that, Stanley.
I like working, Pop. I really do. Listen, I made up my mind. I'm going to write the letter.
How will your principles feel in the morning?
My principles feel better already. You told me you were proud of what I did. That's all I really care about.
Think about it, Stanley. You do what you think is best.
What's the decision?
I'm going to write the letter.
I knew it. I knew he'd make you do it.
I'm doing it on my own. Will you help me write it? You're good at things like that.
The thing is, people used to get paid for that in the old days. Professional letter writers.
I'm not gonna pay you money.
I don't want money.
Then what do you want?
Tell me what Nora looked like naked.
Jesus, how horny can you get?
I don't know. What's the highest score?
The next day, we went to the cemetery because it was 3 years ago today that Uncle Dave died. I asked my mother why everyone put a stone on the grave, and she explained to me because it was the custom. I wanted to say it's a lucky thing the custom wasn't to put orange peels on the grave, but I didn't think she'd appreciate it.
Nora, come on.
I liked Uncle Dave, but I just didn't feel like crying. I hope he's not watching. Nobody but Mom knew that Pop was working nights as a cab driver to make up what he lost from the noisemaker business. He just playing wore out, and he had a minor heart attack. The doctor said it was just a warning, but he had to stop working for a while.
What's the matter?
Everything is all right. It's just that he wasn't feeling well.
He's all right now. We just gave him a lift home. Good night.
Good night.
For the first time in my life, I was really scared. Scared of maybe one day going out to the cemetery and putting a stone on the grave of my father.
About making noise in front of the house. Go to the store, get your father's papers.
Now?
No, next year. And skate on the sidewalk. If you get hit by a truck, don't come running to me.
If I told her I just lost both my hands in an accident, she'd say go upstairs and wash your face with your feet. I paid for the papers.
Your father's a sick man. What are you trying to do, kill him?
What are you talking about?
You think your father's gonna get better if he finds out he's got a son gambling in a pool hall?
Stanley? Is he there now?
Go get him out of there, you hear me? And you stay out of those places. This used to be a nice neighbor.
That's game. You wanna pay up or you wanna go again?
Sure, why not? Rack him up, Gooch.
Hi, Stan.
What are you doing here? Come on home, I'll see you later.
Are you winning?
I'm creaming these guys. Two more games, I can make up Pop's whole salary for the week.
Let me watch. I'll bring you good luck.
Don't need luck against these guys. You shouldn't be in a place like this. Go on, get out of here.
One game. I'm not gonna turn into a bum in one game.
Get out, I said.
sorry. You should do what I tell you.
It's your break.
You should see your mother's new dress. She looks gorgeous.
I'm waiting for her grand entrance. Aunt Kate, if Mama married Mr. Murphy, would we have to live in that dark house across the street with that creepy old woman?
We're not up to that yet. Let's just get through Chardo's restaurant first. Have a cashew. Just one. For the company.
How'd you do?
I told you to go home.
How much did you win? Don't keep me in suspense.
It was a setup. They let me win the first two games, then they doubled the bet. They clawed
me. How much did you lose?
They were hustlers. They go around different neighborhoods and clean everybody out.
Yeah, but how much did you lose?
Everything. My whole salary, $17.
Your whole salary?
Plus the money I won this week in
poker. When did you bet your whole salary?
I thought I could beat them. I beat everybody else around here. Jesus, I think I'm going to throw up.
You must have been hungry. That's a good sign.
I was bored. I had nothing else to do.
Blanche will come in to see her before she goes. Tell her she looks beautiful. You know she's got no confidence.
When was the last time I told you you were beautiful?
Why do you bring that up now?
I realize sometimes I forget to tell people how I feel.
Get better. Take me to the affair next year. Then I'll be beautiful.
He wasn't so sick, I tell him the truth. If he dies, I'll hang myself, I swear.
Why don't you just say you lost the money? You had a hole in your pocket.
I already used that one.
When?
November, when I lost $5. He said, from now on, check your pockets every morning.
What happened to the $5? Did you gamble that, too?
Oh, I gave it to a girl, you know, a pro.
A pro what? A prostitute? She went to one of those places? Holy shit!
I'm not gonna warn you about that word again.
Is that what it cost? $5?
$2.50. I went with this guy I know. He still owes me.
And you never told me. What was she like? Was she pretty? How old was she?
Start in with me, Eugene.
Did she get completely naked or what?
Every time I get in trouble, I have to tell you what a naked girl looks like? Do me a favor. Go in the bathroom, whack off, and grow up by yourself.
I'm going out. I'll be home late. I have my key. Good night.
You're going where?
I have a date with Larry Clurman. We're going to a movie.
Don't you want to see how your mother looks?
I'm sure she looks beautiful. She doesn't need me to tell her.
I think your mother would be very hurt if you didn't wait to say goodbye.
I know exactly how my mother feels, Uncle Jack. I'm not so sure she knows how I feel.
Nora! Nora, you want to come help me? Nora?
Did you cut it out? Damn it, I'm trying to think.
Get sore. It's not my fault what happened.
Yeah, well, I never had an older brother to help me when I was in trouble. I had to do it on my own. You don't know how lucky you are to be the younger one. You don't have the responsibilities I do. You're still in school looking up girls' dresses on the staircase.
I work plenty hard in school.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, let me see your report card. Yesterday was the first of the month. I know you got it. I want to see your report card.
I don't have to show you my report card. You're not my father.
Yes, I am. As long as Pop is sick, I am. I'm the only one in the family who's working, ain't I?
Really? Well, where's your salary this week, Pop?
I hate you sometimes. You're nothing but a lousy shit. I help you all the time. You never help me without wanting something for it. I hate your disgusting guts.
Not as much as I hate yours. You snore at night. You pick your toenails. You smell up the bathroom. When I go in there, I have to puke.
Give me your report card. Give it to me. God damn it, I'll beat your face.
You want it?
Yeah.
Here. Here's my lousy report card. You fuck.
Four A's and a B.
Jack? Jack? Jack, what are you doing down here?
I want to meet this Murphy fellow. A stranger comes in. He likes to meet another man. It makes him feel comfortable.
I got so scared when I didn't see you in your room.
Well, you don't look it. You look beautiful.
Here. Wear these. Don't say no to me. Just let me put them on.
Kate, your pearls, your good pearls.
Now, what are they going to do? Sit in a drawer all year? Pearls are like people. They like to go out and be seen once in a while.
Oh, you were going to wear these to the affair tonight. Oh. I got so wrapped up in myself, I forgot you were missing the affair this year. Oh, I'm so afraid I'll lose them.
Let's see how they look, Mom.
Lori, go up and get Nora. I want to show them to Nora.
She's not here. She left.
What do you mean she left? Without saying goodbye?
She had to go meet somebody, so you'll see her when she comes home.
She could have come to my room. She knew I wanted to see her.
Blanche, you're going out to have a good time. You'll deal with this later.
She's making me pay for it, isn't she? She knows how she can get to me so easily. That's what I get for trying to make decisions.
I feel like ice cream for dessert. Lori, you feel like ice cream?
Butter pecan?
Butter pecan for you. Maple walnut for me. Go up and tell Eugene I want him to go to the store.
She's doing it. She's taking everything off. Today's the day. Please, God, don't let it get foggy.
Eugene, your father wants us to go to the store.
Damn. Tell him I'm sick. Tell him I have diarrhea.
You don't want any ice cream?
Ice cream? Wait a minute. You want some ice cream, Stan?
No.
I have no willpower. How am I going to be a writer unless I suffer? Actually, I'd give up writing if I could see a naked girl while I was eating ice cream.
Wants maple walnut and butter pecan.
Eugene, go to Hanson's. Lori will tell you what to get.
I need money.
I just paid the doctor $15. Go up to Stanley. He got paid today. Ask him for salary.
What?
Here's a dollar. Hurry back so Lori can meet Mr. Murphy.
Come on, I'll race you. I'll hop on one leg.
Not allowed to run.
I'll hop on one leg and hold my breath.
Is she calling us?
I think she's calling you.
What do you think she wants?
She wants you to taste her spider soup.
Stop that! Think I should go?
Sure, she's okay. I'll get the ice cream. Don't stay in there too long, or else you'll become Irish.
Maybe she's not coming back. Maybe she's run off to Boston, Washington, or God knows where.
Is that what you're going to talk about on your date? The man will start drinking in 5 minutes.
You think so? What'll I do if he gets drunk?
You come right home. Do you have money for car fare?
No, I didn't take anything.
Wait here. I'll get $5 from Stanley. Now I have something else to worry about.
Stanley, are you in there?
Open the window. You never get air in this room. I need $5 for Aunt Blanche. Stanley, did you get paid today?
Yeah, I got paid.
I'll take out the money for the week. Let me have the envelope.
I don't have it.
You don't have the envelope.
I don't have the money.
What do you mean you don't have the money?
I mean, I don't have the money. It's gone.
It's gone? Gone where?
It's just gone. I don't have it. I can't get it back. I'm sorry. There's nothing I can do about it anymore. Just don't ask me any more questions.
Wait, what do you mean, don't ask you any more questions? I want to know. What happened to $17, Stanley?
You'll tell Pop. If I tell you, you're going to tell Pop.
Why shouldn't I tell your father? Stanley, I want to know what happened to that money.
I gambled it. I lost it playing pool. All right? You happy? You satisfied now?
I'm not going to think about this now. I have your Aunt Blanche get out of the house first. I have your father's health to worry about. You're going to sit here and you're going to think up a story. You were robbed. Somebody stole the money. That's what you're going to tell your father. Because if you tell him the truth, you'll kill that man as sure as I'm standing here.
Oh, I don't... Why am I so nervous?
I guarantee you he's twice as nervous.
Oh. Oh, shut the door. Stay here. Don't get up. Oh, I thought I heard someone. Kate? What is it?
Oh, it's nothing. I'm just on nerves today.
You worried about Jack. He shouldn't have come down those stairs.
He knows he's not supposed to get out of bed. What do we pay doctors for if he doesn't listen?
I shouldn't have asked Mr. Murphy to come over. That's the only reason Jack came down.
It's not just Mr. Murphy. It's Stanley. It's Eugene. It's everybody. Everybody has a problem here.
Did Nora say something to hurt you, Kate?
Why don't you get your purse? Blanche, she'll be here any minute.
I know. She's been difficult these last few days.
Why is it always Nora? Why is it only your problems? Do you think you're the only one in the world who has troubles? We all have troubles. We all get our equal share.
Well, forgive me. I'm sorry, Kate. I understand. Yes, what?
I have just been in the creepiest place in the whole world.
Not now, Lori. Aunt Kate and I are talking.
I was in Mrs. Murphy's house. She asked if you could come over now. She said it was important.
What is it?
She didn't tell me. I just wanted to get out of there. Then she gave me a green cookie. Yuck.
Maybe he has to work late. I'll be right back, Kate. We'll finish talking.
I would have come over myself, but I have trouble crossing the streets these days. Too many motor cars now.
Of course.
I'm sorry to say I have regrets for my son Frank. He'll not be able to keep his dinner engagement with you this evening. Frank's in hospital.
Dear God, is he all right?
His injuries, thank the Lord, are not serious. But the consequences are... He was driving a friend's motor car while intoxicated. He'll have to face police charges. I'm sure of that. As soon as Frank can get out of his difficulties here, we've decided to move upstate New York, where there's a clinic that can help him and where we have relatives with whom we can stay.
Mrs. Murphy, I'm so terribly sorry. Please tell Frank that I wish him only the best.
Could have been you in that car with him. I warned you the first day about those people.
Stop calling them those people. She's a mother like you and me.
And what is he? Tell me what he is.
He's someone in trouble. He's someone who needs help. I mean, for God's sake, Kate, you don't even know the man.
I know him. I know what they're all like.
Who are you to talk? Are we any better? Are we something so special? We're all poor around here. The least we can be is charitable.
Why? What have I got I can afford to give away? Am I the one who got you all dressed up for nothing? Am I the one who got your hopes up? All I ever did was try to help you.
Nobody cares for their family more than you do, Kate, but you can at least be sympathetic to someone else in trouble.
Who should I care about? Who's out there watching over me? I did enough in my life for people. Ooh, you know what I'm talking about.
No, I don't. Say what's on your mind, Kate. What people?
You! Celia, Papa, when he was sick. Don't you ask me what people. How many beatings did I get from Mama for things that you did? How many dresses did I go without so you could look like somebody when you went out? I was the workhorse. You were the pretty one. You have no right to talk to me like that. You've got no right.
This is all about Jack, isn't it? You're blaming me for what happened to Jack.
Why do you think that man is sick today? Why did a policeman have to carry him home at 3 o'clock in the morning? So your Nora could have dancing lessons. So Laurie could see a doctor every 3 weeks. Go on, you worry about your friend across the street, not the ones who have to be dragged home to keep a roof over your head.
Why didn't you ever tell me how you felt about all this?
I never had time. I was too busy taking care of everybody.
My God, you live with someone your whole life.
My mother and my mother are having a fight.
About what?
Well, my mother was the workhorse, and my mother was the pretty one.
Like this, can't we?
What?
If I could take Nora and Laurie and pack them out of the house tonight, I would. But I can't. I have no place to take them. If I could leave the girls with you another few weeks, I would appreciate it until I can find a place of my own. And then I'll send for them.
Blanche, don't talk like that.
The ice cream.
Not now.
I know a woman in Manhattan Beach. I can stay with her for a few days. And then I'll find a job. I'll do anything anybody asks me. But I will never be a burden to anyone as long as I live.
Blanche, stop this. What the hell is going on here, for God's sakes? Two sisters having a fight they should have had 25 years ago? Tell her, Kate, what it is to be an older sister. Call her names, Blanche. Tell her to go to hell for the first time in your life. And when you both get it out of your system, give each other a hug and go have dinner. My lousy ice cream is melting, for God's sakes.
No matter what Kate says to me, I will never stop loving her. But I have to get out. If I don't do it now, I'll lose what little self-respect I have left. And when I grow old, I wish I have as much self-respect as Mrs. Matthew Murphy from across the street.
Something happened for you to behave like this. It wasn't Blanche. It was something else. What?
Tell the kids we're eating in the kitchen tonight.
Never to run away.
I'm not running away. I'm leaving. Only kids run away. Does Pop know about my losing my salary?
You told Mom that. Why? I came up with 12 terrific lies for you.
I have to go.
I have some money for you. It's only $1.12, but it's my life savings.
I can make it all right.
Please stand. Take the money.
I'll pay you back. If there's a war, I'll become a sergeant. I hear they make real good dough.
If it lasts long enough, I could join too. Maybe we could get in the same outfit.
You don't go in the army unless they come and get you. You go to college. Promise me you'll go to college.
Don't leave, Stan. They'll get over it. They won't stay mad at you forever. I was mad at you. I got over it.
I'm nothing but trouble, Gene. Don't turn out to be like me.
I don't see what's so bad about you.
Take care of yourself, Huge. Write a story about me. Call me Hank. I always liked the name Hank.
I guess there comes a time in everyone's life when you say, this very moment is the end of my childhood. When Stanley got on that train, I knew that moment had come to me. I was scared. I was lonely. And I hated my mother and father for making him so unhappy. I even hated Stanley a little. Because he left me there to grow up by myself. I tried to hold out as long as I could, but I knew they'd find out sometime, so I just said it. I told them that Stanley had run off to join the army.
What army?
The U.S. Army. How many armies are there?
Never. Not without talking to me first, not Stanley. Ketchup?
I saw him leave on the train. He won't be back tonight, you'll see.
He's walking around in New York. He's upset because we had a fight. If it gets cold enough, he'll be back.
Fight about what? A fight about what?
He lost his salary. He gambled in a pool hall. He lost the whole $17.
He just tried to make back the money Pop lost being out of work. That's why he did it. That's why he joined the army.
He should have talked to me.
I'm his father! matter, goddammit? What, is he afraid to talk to me?
Why? He didn't want to tell you. He loves you. He loves you so much.
I don't give a goddamn about his love.
He didn't want to excite you.
From the sound of it, I figured Stanley should forget about the army and join the Foreign Legion.
Get into bed.
I wanted to talk to you.
How was your dinner?
I didn't go. Mr. Murphy was in an accident.
I'm sorry. Is he all right?
He has his problems, like the rest of us. I was very upset that you left tonight without saying goodbye. You have never done that before.
Can we talk about this in the morning?
I'm leaving, Nora. I'm moving out in the morning.
What are you talking about?
Aunt Kate and I had a fight. We said some terrible things to each other. I'm going to stay with my friend Louise in Manhattan Beach until I can find a job. Then I'll send for you and Lori.
I can't believe it. You mean it's all right for you to leave us, but it wasn't all right for me to leave you?
I was never concerned about your leaving me. It was your future I was worrying about.
So I have to give up the one chance I may never get again. Is that it? I'm the one who has to pay for what you couldn't do with your own life?
What right do you have to judge me like that?
Judge you? I can't even talk to you. I don't exist to you. I have tried so hard to get close to you, but there was never any room. Whatever you had to give went to Daddy. And when he died, whatever was left, you gave to...
Finish what you were going to say.
I have been jealous my whole life of Lori because she was lucky enough to be born sick. I used to pray that I would get some terrible disease or get hit by a car so that I would have a leg all twisted and crippled. And then once, just once, maybe I get to crawl into bed next to you on a cold, rainy night and talk to you and hold you until I fell asleep in your arms. Just once.
My God, Nora. Is that what you think of me?
Is it any worse than what you think of me?
I am not going to let you hurt me. I'm not going to be a doormat for all the frustrations and unhappiness that you or Aunt Kate or anyone else wants to lay at my feet. I did not create this universe. I do not decide who lives or dies, or who's rich or poor, or who feels loved, and who feels deprived. If you feel cheated that Lori gets more than you do, I feel cheated that my husband died at 36. I'm sorry that you feel unloved, Nora, and I will do everything I can to change it. But I will not go back to being that frightened, helpless woman that I created. I already buried someone I love. Now it's time to bury someone I hate.
Sam now. You'll hear from us in 3 weeks. Don't look so worried, son. We're gonna make a man out of him.
I'll carry my load, don't worry.
Okay, soldier, sign here. Something wrong?
What?
Well, I'm going. I didn't want to leave without saying goodbye.
Blanche! Don't go. I feel bad enough for what I said. Don't make me feel any worse.
As God is in heaven, there will never be an angry word between you and me again, Kate. But I'm afraid of being comfortable here. If I don't get out now, when will I ever do it?
Well, the door is open. Go whenever you want. Get a job first. Get your apartment first. I'll find out about the Murphy place. Couldn't be very expensive. She never cleaned it.
How independent can I become if I live right across the street from you?
Far enough away for you to close your own door. And close enough for me not to feel so lonely.
Okay, 29-7. Let's go!
Come on, Tony, make him hit it. No batter in there.
I got it!
Stan!
Hi.
Well, what happened?
Did you join up? Came pretty close. I passed the physical, 1, 2, 3.
I knew you would.
But then just as I was about to sign my name, I stopped cold and walked out.
How come?
Couldn't do it to Pop. Right now, he needs me more than the Army does.
I thought you'd be halfway to training camp by now.
But I'm real glad you're home. Stay.
Hi, Mom. Stanley's home.
You have to go back to Greenblatt's. I need a pint of sweet cream and some more sugar. Get me a 2-pound bag. I want to make a chocolate cake.
A 2-pound bag from Greenblatt? I'll need identification.
How are you, Mom?
Are you staying for dinner?
I'm staying as long as you'll let me stay.
Why shouldn't I let you stay? This is your home. Your father's been very worried. I think you owe him an explanation.
Acrid yellowish smoke billowed yesterday around the Hindenburg Palace. Bombing planes, chased by pursuit ships, streaked across the sky as Adolf Hitler prepared for a visit by Benito Mussolini. Their fascist Nazi mission, they proclaim,
Hi, Pop.
Is to save
Europe. How you feeling?
From communism. Indications were that neither Mussolini nor Hitler wanted to...
I'm sorry about not coming home last night. I just didn't know how to tell you about the money.
Don't you know, Stanley, there's nothing you could ever do that was so terrible I couldn't forgive you? I know why you gambled. I know how miserable you feel. I lost money gambling in my time. I know what it's like.
You did?
You're so surprised? You think your father's a perfect human being? You go through life thinking I was perfect. You'll hate yourself for every mistake you ever make. Don't be so hard on yourself. You're a good son, Stanley.
I gambled away $17, and you're telling me how terrific I am.
Hey, wait a minute. Don't get the wrong idea. If you were home last night when your mother told me, I would have thrown you and your clothes out the window. Today I'm calmer. Today I heard the radio. Today I'm afraid for all of us.
I understand.
All right. After lunch, apologize to your mother. And apologize to your Aunt Blanche, because she was worried about you too.
I will.
And you can thank your brother as well. He came into my bedroom this morning and told me how badly you felt. The way he pleaded your case, I thought I had Clarence Darrow in the room.
Are you coming in to eat? Lunch is getting cold.
I just want to wash up. Can I talk to you after lunch, Mom?
Where am I going? To a nightclub?
all right. Everything is all right.
Who said it wasn't? Didn't I say he'd be home?
Of course you did.
Minutes, 22 seconds, an Olympic record for going to Greenblatt. Where's Stanley?
Upstairs.
Here's some mail for you, Pop.
Oh, my God, he ate a pound and a half of sugar.
Are you back in the family?
Yeah, everything's great. Pop told me you stuck up for me this morning.
Yeah, I was brilliant.
Well, to show you my appreciation, I brought you a present.
What kind of present?
Promise me you'll keep it someplace safe.
I will. I will. What's my present?
Here, use it in good health.
What is it?
Close your eyes.
Come.
Close your eyes. Now look.
Oh, my God. She's naked. You can see everything.
Don't get caught with a thing like that.
Who is she?
She's French. That's how all the women are in Paris.
You mean some girl actually posed for this? She just laid there and let some guy take a picture?
It belongs to the guy who owes me $2.50. I could keep it until he pays me back.
Don't take the money. Let him owe you for a while.
Put it in a safe spot. Come on, it's lunch.
In a minute. I'll be down in a minute.
I got more for who wants it.
Ta-da!
Oh, I'm so glad to see you home, Stanley. So worried about you.
I'm glad to see you here too, Aunt Blanche.
Oh.
Hi, Stan.
Hey, Squirt. Got your nose.
So funny.
Oh, God. Oh, my God.
What is it? What's wrong, Jack?
It's a letter from London. My cousin Sholem got out. They got out of Poland. They're free, Kate.
Oh, thank God.
His wife, his mother, all 6 children. They're sailing for New York tomorrow. They'll be here in a week.
In a week?
Do they speak English?
I don't think so. A few words, Maria.
Oh, no, somebody wrote this for him.
Mm. Look, they had to sell everything. They took only what they could carry.
Where will they stay?
Well, I'll have to discuss it with the family. Some with Uncle Sol, Uncle Eddie.
With us. We can put some beds in the dining room. I like eating in the kitchen anyway.
The little ones could stay with Lori. And Nora can sleep with me, can't you, dear?
Of course, Mama.
Don't worry about money, Pa. I'm going to hit Mr. Strohheim for that raise.
They got out. That's all that's important. They got out.
Here is that boy again.
Yes, sir.
Eugene, we're all waiting for you.
Be right there. I'm doing something.
Okay.
October the 2nd, 1937. An historic moment in the life of Eugene Morris Jerome. I have just seen the Golden Palace of the Himalayas. Puberty is over. Onwards and upwards!